Do you know the feeling when you want to right-click but just can't? I certainly do. You can do a lot of things about this, but the most obvious is grip tape. I'm going to test a few grip tapes in this video, for example taser, masking tape, electrical tape, an original razor-like grip tape, and I'm going to give each a score, first in how easy it is to apply, then bridging, reducing clutches, and then an all-in-all score over my overall opinion about them. If you like this kind of video, leave a like, leave a comment, consider subscribing, and have fun with the video. Hey guys, welcome to this video, and today I'm going to compare a few grip tapes. And first we got Tesa. This is this kind of grip tape. I think everybody of you should have this at home. It's see-through tape and it's pretty common. How to apply this tape? You need to rip a piece off, which is about the length of your mouse, and then you need to cut it off and you need to put it on your mouse button. You see, it fits pretty good. But there's like an area on the front where it's too much, and I recommend you grabbing a small scissor, and then you can cut the piece which is over the mouse button off, and then it fits perfectly on your mouse. So the width is perfect, you just need to adjust the length. But we are not done yet. You also need to apply adding on this mouse. So with just taser, you don't have good grip. You also need to apply adding. This is the part which gives you grip. So just taser don't is grippy at all. But the adding on the taser is grippy. And I'm going to do this on the other side of the mouse now. So I'm going to give this tape in the first category one of these stars. Of course, it's not that inconvenient, but you do need to do a little bit of stuff. And you also need to reapply the adding because it wears off after like an hour or so. You need to reapply it. And you also get a little bit of adding on your hand by drag clicking. And that brings us to the next part. How good can you bridge with this method? So we are in a game of bridging, and I'm mostly going to concentrate on short drag click because that's the most important thing about bridging. And with this method, you have too much grip. So if you got adding on the mouse, I have too much grip, so I move with my mouse, so I can't got bridge with short drag clicks, because either I don't drag click that much because I get too less CPS. So if I just like do this, I don't drag click, I just double tap, and if I want to drag click, I move with my mouse. So all these bridging methods are impossible. You need to hold your mouse, and in my opinion, it's a lot harder to do this bridging methods by holding your mouse. So it's getting 1 out of 3 stars with bridging because it's just really inconvenient, and we're gonna see us in a game of reduce. So we are in a game of MLG Rush, and I also don't quite like this tape for reducing. So you can drag click less good than without any tape, and I can do shorter drag clicks. I like, it's really bad. So you see, I can't really reduce. I try my best, but I get way too much grip. So I can't really reduce, or I can't really drag click that good. Either I get too much grip or I get too less grip. And maybe if you don't have any grip on your mouse at all, this could improve it, but for most people, I would not recommend this. So in reducing, it's also getting a 1 out of 3, and we're gonna see us in a game of clutches. So now we are in clutches, and I don't really like it for clutches as well. As I said before, it's not that easy to drag click with it, so you can't do clutches all that great, and you also can't drag click that long. So normally I can drag click on this cane really long, and now I can just do really short drag clicks, so it's impossible to do any clutches. So I'm giving it a 1 in here as well. So all in all, well, I would give Tesa 1 point out of 3, so it's really not worth it, and I really wouldn't recommend buying it. So we got the next tape, which is masking tape. And this is harder to apply than the first because it's wider, but you can also buy this in the same width which is the mouse. That's not a negative point, I just bought a wrong one. But then you can just apply it on your mouse, and now you don't need to like get a scissor. You can just like rip it off. If you want to reuse a scissor, you can use a scissor. And now I got it applied on my mouse, and with this tape you can do adding on it. You don't need to put adding on it, but it sometimes improves your grip. So the negative aspect on this tape is that you need to have red fingers. So if you are a really sweaty guy and you sweat while gaming, it's really good, but if you got dry fingers, you can't right click at all. And adding improved this a little bit. If I don't have grip, I would certainly try out adding. But all in all, it's not perfect to apply because sometimes you need to put adding on it, and so I would give it 1 star at how to apply as well. So we are at bridging. I quite really like this tape for bridging, so you can do short right clicks pretty good, so you don't move at all. So I can do short right clicks and like I don't move, or barely move, so I can do short right clicks really long, and can do like moonwalk or so really long. I don't really like it for incline god bridging, so you can do incline god bridge with short right clicks normally perfectly, so it's pretty good for that. But if you want to do incline god bridging with long right clicks, I don't think it's all that amazing. So you can do it, but it feels really unsafe, and I can do like 5 to 6 blocks at a time with one direct click, and that's not all that much. So I would give it an overall rating of 2 out of 3, because it's okay, but long direct click in bridging isn't all that great. So we are in a game of MLG Rush, and you can reduce amazingly good with this tape. So you can reduce perfectly. You see I get 20 to 30 CPS. I can reduce without any floor, so it's really good for reducing. If you want to reduce, this tape is really nice. So it gets 3 out of 3 stars in reducing. So we are in clutches, and you can do really good clutches with this tape. The long drag click is really good for clutches. So it fits really good for clutches. I didn't like the long drag click for bridging, but for clutches it's really good. So I would give it a 3 out of 3 for clutches. And overall this tape is really good. I would give it 2 out of 3 points, and if you got it laying around, you can definitely try it out. But there are 2 negative factors. First of all, you see it, so it's pretty obvious, and somebody who doesn't know it looks at your mouse and thinks like, what the heck are you putting on your mouse? And the second aspect is you need wet fingers. If you got dry fingers, you can't direct click. So I got a lot of moments where I used this tape and you couldn't direct click. That's a really big negative factor, and we're gonna see us with the next tape. So the next tape is electrical tape. You see this is black, so you can't see it on the mouse at all, and you can put it on simply. You need to rip something off, then you need to cut it, and then you need to put it on your mouse, and then you see at the front and in the back there's something sticking over the edge, and I need to cut it off. But you can also do this pretty fast, so it's pretty easy to apply as well. And in my testing there was a difference when putting 1 or 2 pieces or even 3 pieces of tape on this mouse. So for me 2 or 3 pieces work the best, but you need to find the perfect sweet spot for you. So maybe you need to put 2 layers of this, or maybe 3, or maybe 1, and try with which you can direct click the best. So it's pretty easy. You don't need to put adding on this, but because you need to put like maybe 2 or maybe 3 layers of this, it's not really all that convenient, and I would give it also 1 out of 3 stars while applying. For bridging, it's amazing how good you can bridge with this tape. So like with masking tape, you can do short right clicks without moving at all. So I can do this and I like barely move or don't move at all. So I can infinitely long moonwalk or do other bridging methods without touching my mouse. So you just need to learn the timing. So it's really good for this bridging methods. You can also do tele bridge with this, because you can really good do long right clicks. So it's also really good for tele bridging. I also like it for inclined. So inclined with short right clicks is as easy as with masking tape. But you can also do inclined with long right clicks. So I can really good do inclined with long direct clicks, and it's far better than with masking tape. So I would give this tape 3 out of 3 points by bridging, because you can do perfect short direct clicks, and you can also do really long direct clicks which you need for inclined god bridging. So we are in a game of MLG Rush, and you can reduce really good with this tape. You can reduce as good as with masking tape. So for like middle long drag clicks which you need while reducing, it's perfect. You get 30, so around 30 CPS with the cane, or I get around 30 CPS with the cane. So it's really good for that. And I would give it 3 out of 3 points for doing reduce, because you get the CPS, you can drag click flawlessly while reducing, and I think it's perfect for this. So we are in the clutches, and I also really like this tape for clutches. It's perfect, the drag click is perfect for clutches, so you can do really good short drag clicks, but you can also do really good long drag clicks, better than with masking tape. So it's a little bit better in clutches than masking tape. They are not like far ahead, so it's like they are on the edge. Really close to each other, and I also would give this 3 points in clutches. So overall, I would give this tape a 3 out of 3 because while it isn't the easiest or the fastest to apply, it's really good for bridging, for reducing and for doing clutches, and you do apply it once and you need to change it like every month or so. I think this point is weaker and it got a really really good positive aspect that you don't see it, so you don't get any negative comments from like your parents or so that they say, what did you put on your mouse? Because if you don't look for it, you don't see it. So I need to put my mouse really really close to this camera that you see I put tape on this. Also your parents need to go really really close and look really really hard at your mouse to see it. It's perfect. And now we're going to test original grip tape. So here got two pieces of original grip tape, and it's pretty easy to apply them. You just need to get them off of this piece where they come, and then you just need to put them on your mouse and it's done. So it takes like 1 second and it's done. Incredible easy to put this on your mouse. 3 out of 3 points. Nobody can fail this, and it's also not that obvious. Certainly if you look for this you see it, but it also could be part of this mouse. And I'm going to show you how good it is at bridging. It's not my favorite tape for bridging because you also have too much grip. So when you do short drag clicks, you move. So you need to hold your mouse while drag clicking. So short drag clicks are not that great. And for incline guard bridging, you can do incline with short drag clicks, but it doesn't feel as safe as with the tape before. And you can forget to do it with long drag clicks. You can't do this. If I do long drag clicks, I can barely place 4 blocks. You can't do this. So I would give it 1 out of 3 stars because it's not that great for bridging. You can't really do bridging with this tape, and I wouldn't buy it for bridging. In MLG Rush, it's the same story. You get too much grip, so you need to drag click really, really soft. You can reduce, so I can reduce really, really good, but it does feel unsafer. But if I would just do MLG Rush, it's okay, but not more. I feel a little bit more unsafe, and maybe in Bad Wars I would fail more often with this than without anything, but it's okay, and I would get a 2 out of 3 stars while reducing. In clutches, it's the same story as with bridging. It's too grippy, you can't do really really long drag clicks with it, and in clutches you need to do long drag clicks. So if I want to do a clutch, I need to do really really long drag clicks. You can do this, but it's hard, and you need to drag click really 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 soft. And it's better in clutches than for bridging, but I wouldn't buy this if I would do clutches. So it's okay, it gets 2 out of 3 points, but I don't think you could do like a 50 plus clutch with this tape, because it's just really 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 inconvenient. And all in all, I would give this tape 1 to 2 points. While it's okay for reducing, it's not that good for bridging, or not useful for bridging at all, and you need to bridge a lot in Bad Wars. And it's also not that great for doing clutches. And while it's really, really nice to apply it, I wouldn't buy it again. So I bought it, and I really wouldn't recommend you buying this or any original tape, like Razor Grip Tape or anything about this. So my conclusion, electrical tape is the best, it's by far the best, and I would everybody recommend either buying electrical tape or buying masking tape and then adding, and I would not recommend Tesa or original tape, because they two are far worse than the first two. You really feel a really good improvement with electrical tape or masking tape, and the other things just worsen the mouse, so it's better without any tape than with this tape. I hope I could show you which tape is the best. I left some Amazon affiliate links in the description, and enjoy drag clicking.